啊，英文先开始
好 OK
OK I put the English first OK today we are exposing another three length alienation exercise of a similar habit of Adena's administration alienation in bulk I mean in bulk acreage and also alienation in a very cheap price. As usual, as Adena's usual, of 300 per acres. So today, three alienation exercise. Upon the thorough research and data collection, I have discovered another three length cheap cell exercise under Adena's administration since he took office as a Chief Minister of Sarawak on the 1st of March 2014. So this will be the 4th, 5th and 6th alienation exercise of 300 ringgit per acres of agricultural land, alright, that we expose. The details are as per the tables that I provided. The first three the documents has been disclosed to the press in previous occasions, i.e. the first exposure on the 17th of March 2014, Lot 22, Lot 41, Block 2, Sambadi Land District. In total, 22 parcels of land, in total acreage of 3,121.33 acres at Lundu, alienated to Genuine Formation Central Bahad at 282 per acres. Number two, the second case, 9th of January 2015, alienated on this date, Lot 6 and 7, Block 4, Buloh Land District at Balingian, in total acreage of 6,765.6 acres. Alienated to Green Pro Farm Central Berhad at 300 per acre. The case number three, 2nd of March 2015, 1 year after Adena's assumed office as Chief Minister, Lot 1 Block 24 Anak Land District at Tatau Bintulu, total acreage 7,002.81 acres. Alienated to Ikra Bumi Central Berhad. The price was at 300 per acre. Today, the three cases, all the documents I have shared with you. The fourth case, 26th of May 2014, Lot 1, Block 50, Kemena Land District. 6,417.19 acres at Jalan Bintulu Sibu, alienated to S Light Development Central Berhad. So, the total alienation price, the premium, I mean, is 1.9 something million ringgit Malaysia. It means that 300 per acres. This can be found at page three. Page 3, if you flip to page 3, item 1F4, this is the doomed answer given to me. Item 1F4, S-Line Development Central Berhad, 2,592 hectares, it means I translate into acreage, is 6,000 plus. The premium was 1.9 plus, alright? 1.9 million plus. So, in average of 300 per acres. Okay, if you go behind, there is a land search at page 5 of this particular land. So I'm speaking from the documents, I'm speaking from the evidence. Alright, Lot 1, Block 50, Kemena Land District. The acreage, you can see at line number 3, and also the commencement and expiry date, if you can see the last third line of the land search was alienated on the 26th of May 2014. Alright, this is how we read the land search. And then at page 7, you can see the owner's information at section 2, has light development syndrome heart. Alright, so this is the charge. You can see the charge, you know the value of the land. The charge is 20 over million and all that, you see. But of course, it's in conjunction with another piece of land which they share the common characters. I will go into that. Alright, so page 9 is the S-Line Development Syndrome Heart Company search. So page 9 onwards, you can page 11, S-Line Development Syndrome Heart, nature of business, no operation. It's a domain company. No operation company can be alienated with land. With such a huge land with such a cheap price. Page 11 shows the directors of S-Light Development Center Bahan. Dr. Ding Liang Chung of Solid Timber. That we know that, alright? And his directors, alright? Solid Timber Boss, yeah. Alright. So this is the fourth case, all right? The fifth case, if we flip to the, go back to the first page, fifth case, also 26th of May 2014, but Lot 7, Block 18, Buan Land District, at Jalan Bintulu. Times 2.471, you can get the acreage. Alright, 6,500 plus acres at Jalan Bintulu Sibu, and last three lines of the first of the page of 15, date of registration and date commencement, that is 25th of May 2014. This is after Adenam became chief minister. So if we flip to page 17, the owner information, Solid Continental Central Bank. Alright? And you can see that there is a charge also 20 over million. Alright? Solid Continental Central. S-Light Development Center Bahan. Dr. Ding Lian Chung also, and his Ding Ying Kung, Ho Kian Sing, all the common directors of S-Light. You can cross refer to that. Alright? Solid Continental. Alright? And also at page 22, the company is the shareholder. Quality Avenue Center Bahan is the shareholder of this Solid Continental Center Bahan. I also do a company search on qualities. Avenue Central Bahar can be found at page 25. Alright. And you can see the director of Quality Avenue Central Bahar at page 27. Common director of Solid Continental and also common director of S-Light Development. Dr. Dean Lenger again. Alright. Alright, so the premium of this, the fifth case, can be found at page 3. Page 3, there is a Dung answer given to me at item 185. The premium, the last second column, 1.95 million. Alright, it's offset, okay. Alright, this is the fifth case. Now I go to sixth case. Alienated on 14th of August 2014, two parcels of land, lot 4 and lot 5, block 51, Kemena Land District, in total acreage of 906.86 acres. It's comparatively is a smaller piece of land, but it's huge. 900 acres. It's huge. Located at Bindulu Miri Costa Road, alienated to Kelopak Mekah Sendirian Berhad at the total price of 271,000 plus ringgit Malaysia. It means 300 per acres also. Alright, so the premium can be found at page 4 at item 919 and 912. Two pieces of land, lot 4 and lot 5. Lot 5 is smaller, a very small one, 5 hectares. Alright, lot 4 is 362 hectares. The total premium is that. Alright, so it's 300 ringgit per acres. Okay, so the land search of lot 4 and lot 5 can be found at page 31. Lot 4, date of registration, the second last line, 14th of August 2014. The owner can be found at page 33, Kelopak Mekah Sendirian Berhad. Lot 5, also the same date, 14th August 2014, can be found at page 34. The owner of this land, page 36, Kelopak Mekah Sendirian Berhad. So two pieces, evidence is here. And company search of Kelopak Mekah Sendirian Berhad. I don't know whether the chairman can know the person or not. Page 37, you look at the last line of Kelopak Mekah Sendirian Berhad, page 37, company search. The company was domain. All are domain company, and yet they got a big piece of land of that name. Director, page 36, Yusof Bin Wahab. Dato Haji Yusof Bin Wahab. Chung Tek Wai. Muhammad Razali Bin Hamdeng. All with the address at Miri. So they have been there before the alienation of land. Or as a director, as directors. So the shareholder can be found at page 40. Also these three persons with a majority shareholder, Yusof Bin Wahab, Dato' Haji Yusof Bin Wahab. Alright. So how many more lands have been sold at 300 ringgit per acres? Cheap selling state land policy by Antonina administration is only enriching cronies and making our own people our Sarakian quarter. It is reasonable to believe that out of the total that we discover is 30,000 plus acres of land for these six cases. Out of the 30 acres plus acres of land, it may involve a lot of NCR lands. The habit of Adenan administration selling land cheaply will render us and our future generation landless Sarawakian. It's huge, alright, 30,000 acres of land within 2 years. Adenan became chief minister, and he is asking for another 5 years. Alright, the market price of agricultural lands of this kind could range between 3,000 to 8,000 per acres, depending on its locality. Not only agricultural land, our chairman, Bichong also exposed land opposite MNJC 267 acres sold to Center Parade Development Center Berhad, prime land. Apart from agricultural land, prime land also is sold as a meager price of 110 million, which the market price of the land is approximately 500 million. The said parcel of land was transferred to the company by merely 10% of the purchase price. What's that? All right. Until today, CM Adenang or SOP did not respond to our demand for explanation on this matter. I was even present personally to Chief Minister's office to seek for explanation with all the documents with me, but there was no answer given to. So, CM Adenang and SOP are asking DIP to talk about local issues. This is an issue, one of the local issues that we want to talk about and we brought up. So Adenang, we demand for an answer. All right. Okay, 今天是我们揭露的第四宗、第五宗和第六宗种植地被贱卖300亿某。好，之前我们有三宗的这个种植地，揭露了三宗的种植地，我放在这个图表里面。就是第一宗是在伦敦的地，我就没有仔细过出了，就在这个里面。第一宗是在伦敦，3000多亿亩，3125亿亩。第二宗是在万宁年，6765亿亩，都是差不多300块。第三宗是在达到彼得路，7002亿亩，300块一亩。今天我们要揭露的是另外的三宗，是。 在图表里面的第四，就是5月26号2014年，阿德南成为首席部长过后，的差不多三个月，两个月，加兰比都路西部的路，的地 Lot E Block 50 Kemenaland Street 6417亿亩，用190多万。 马币批出去就是讲300块一亩。第五宗是批给 Solid Continental Sandra Bahar， 是在加兰比都路西部6500多一亩，6506.14，那是第五宗 Lot 7 Block 18 Guan Land District， 也是300块一亩。 第六宗是 Lot 4和 Lot 5 Binduru Mili Coastal Road 批给 Kloba Mecca Central Park Kemenar Land District 906亿亩，也是300块亿亩。总共这六宗我们所揭发的六宗的这个建价卖政府币的案件， 总共涉及了3979.93亿亩，这是很大的一片土地。后面的这个文件，我就交给你们去看。OK，我就没有播出。OK，到底还有多少片这样的地被贱卖300块一亩，种植地300块一亩？阿德南在短短的这个两年。 的首席部长的任期里面，已经批了3719.93亿亩，我们所揭发的，到底还有多少？阿德南政府这样贱卖沙洲政府地，只是自负国政分担，但是它会使沙捞越人民更加的贫穷。 因为沙洲的财富不是沙捞越人民共享，而且我们很有理由能够怀疑，能够知道的是，这3万亿亩的地，在短短两年里面批出去，将会涉及许多的。 土著习俗地的问题，阿德南这样批地的做法，会导致我们沙捞越人这一代以及下一代变成无地的沙捞越人 （landless Sarawakian）。 不只是种植地贱卖，我们也看到黄金地、商业地也贱卖。 好，这个种植地的市价是3000到8000不等，好，看一下它的这个地区，好，越靠近有路的啊，有水和电的啊，可能啊，它的就很蛮贵一亩，平常最少一亩3000到8000之间，好，这是市价，好，3000到8000，不是300块，绝对不是300块，好，除了种植地，也有黄金商业地被贱卖，其中一个例子就是 MJC 对面的那一片267英亩的地，我们沙洲主席张建仁，哦，在州议会已经有提过了，贱卖1.1亿，哦，1.1亿，市价是5亿，哦，但是这间给这个 Standard Paris Development Center 吧，这间公司1.1亿只花了18天地就过给他，哦，所以对彭达特别友善，哦，阿迪南政府对彭达是特别友善，特别关照，哦，特别的恩待，但是对沙瑞百姓却没有，哦，这样，所以到今天阿迪南首席部长阿迪南或者人联党，哦，我们都没有看到有任何的回应，他们说捍卫沙劳越，哦，这是所谓的捍卫沙劳越，哦，捍卫沙劳越彭达，哦，不是捍卫沙劳越人民。就算我亲自到这个首席部长的办公室要求解释，我携带了所有的证据去，但是首席部长也不能够给予任何的这个指示，也没有出来见我，哦，所以首席部长跟领导一直说，哦，我们要讲地方性州性的问题 local issue， 在这个沙洲选举这就是 local issue 地方性议题，哦，所以我们要首席部长谈这个解释这个，哦，Any question? Anything not clear?
In the case of India, there are several companies, but maybe the same name.
Not necessary, but case number 4. Okay, the directors of all the 6 cases that we expose, only 4th and 5th cases are involving common directors. Other than that, are all different.General information, Sandra Berhad. The first case belonged to Chris Chung. 99% of share. Chris Chung. Green Pro Farm, Sandra Berhad, at that time, two unknown young men. Ikra Bumi, Sandra Berhad, involving Thai family. Alright. S-Light Development, Solid Continental, Sandra Berhad, is related to solid timber. Oh.Kelopa Mekha Sandra Berhad belong to Dato' Haji Yusof, majority shareholder. OK, 有什么问题吗？这后面的文件 OK 吗？好，可以 refer 一下。
好。
So
if we give the non-major finders, what would be the red light? The red meaning?
Maybe let us put in context. Let us put in context or quantify how much Sarawakian has lost. All right, with the expose of this cheap sell state land policy in respect of the 6 parcels of this state land, plus that.Big that 267 acres in Batukawa, Jalan Batukawa, opposite MJC. Let us give a figure, an estimated figure of what Sarawakian has lost to the because of this these 7 parcels of land, cheap sale. Alright, the estimated market value 5,000 per acre for those six parcels, 30,000 acres, roughly 5,000 per acre market price. It was cheap sold at 300 per acre. Okay, this alone, Sarawakian general public has lost 140 million. 140 million. Okay, it is 4,000,000. For the land, the parcel of land opposite MJC, sold at 115 million, 115 million by the state government. The market price was, it was about 500 million. And I managed to source for her potential buyer, alright, who offer 600 million to the state government. Okay, provided the state government approved the plan, tentative plan that he prepared. So all in, for that parcel of land, the public, the general Sarawakian lost about 500 million plus this 140 million. So in these 7 parcels of land alone, Sarawakian has lost 640 million because of this cheap sell state land policy of ADINA. 640 million was lost. How much can this 640 million do?
Million.
How much can this 640 million help the general public of Sarawakian? Alright, I think this is the issue at hand. This is a local issue, and this is the policy that Adinan inherited and continued from his predecessor, Taib Mahmud. Alright, that's why we say his policy is no better than Taib Mahmud's policy. He may give out some goodies to the people in terms of abolishing quit rent. Okay, for small holders or residential houses. All in, the government's reduced revenue is about 8 million. All in a year, the government's reduced revenue. The general public pay less. The whole, all 30 million, 3 million Sarawakian pay less by 8 million. Okay. But on the other hand, these 7 parcels of land which we expose about Adinan, the Sarawak people has lost 640 million.
Oh,
600 million. I think you can build
20 million or so.
If you give a high estimate of a school, 10 million a school or 15 million a school, a very good school, 15 million will be about 40 schools. 10 schools will be 100 million, 150 million. 42 schools. 42 grade A schools. Oh, yeah, with equipment. Right, 所以这个整个 今天暴露的到目前为止 阿尼南说他要 要做一个清廉的政府， 但是他还是延续 白毛当年的政策， 就是贱卖政府地。 这六宗， 刚才庆伟所暴露的， 加上我在 我所暴露的视角的 那一片 267英亩的政府地 贱卖， 被贱卖。 如果我们跟市价来比较， 沙拉越人民已经损失了6亿4千万，而这6亿4千万也变成了朋党的私利。所以在这种这个很明显的，阿迪南根本就没有真正的去改革沙州的政府的错误的经济政策，还是贱卖国产给朋党。哦，他可能有试行一些，小恩小惠的民粹政策，但是在整体的经济政策上，他并没有实施任何改革，而且还是照顾朋党利益，所以这最终还是会加剧沙州人民的这个贫富鸿沟。所以这种经济垄断政策在百毛时代开始，到了阿迪南时代还是延续下去。OK。OK。阿迪南 challenge me to talk about local issue。OK。Well, I accept his challenge. He can set the time for the debate between myself and him. Anytime, any place. Even live telecast. Or maybe RTM can help to facilitate a debate on local issue. And I would like to ask him, when all Sarawakians are made to pay GST and suffer under GST, is that local or not? Are we paying in, not in Sarawak, are we paying the GST in West Malaysia? All 3 million Sarawakians are paying GST in Sarawak when they are consuming goods. Consuming services and goods, GST. So, is that not local to Sarawakian? It's not everyday lives of Sarawakian as you can get. Alright, and is it not the fault of 25 BN MPs in parliament that caused the sufferings of the people? These are questions that I'll throw to him. On the land alienation issue, this is also local issue. We accept the challenge, and I ask him to name the place and time for a public debate, preferably on air. All right.
Let everybody
be the judge. Okay.
Free admission.
Okay. Yeah, free admission also can. Alright, 所以今天阿迪娜的挑战要我们提只讲本地课题。好，我相信沙劳越每个人在还 GST 的时候都是在沙劳越在还 GST。GST 的实施影响人民的生活，影响商家的生意，这些都是道道地地沙州人的问题，而且归根究底罪魁祸首还是那25位沙州的国政国会议员在国会里面支持 GST 的通过，不然的话 GST 就不能够通过，也不会影响沙劳越人民。好，所以 GST 的实施切切地地的是一个沙州的这个本地的一个人民所每天面对的问题，包括这些土地贱卖土地，这个也是沙州政府的问题，沙州人民的问题。所以我接受他的挑战，并疫情他指定时间地点方式，我们来个一场辩论，政府政策如何影响沙州人民。然后我希望他不要回避或者逃避。 Alright, I hope he will not avoid the debate. 这个辩论，这场辩论可以直播，让全骚扰乐人。What are the five finger tycoons? Five, the proxies. Yeah, proxies.
Proxy.
Alright, the question is, Adinan was, talking about fighting, combating illegal loggings and all this. Yet, he is building your question is five timber tycoons. Alright, I will say he's fielding five proxies of timber tycoons as BN direct candidate, right? Now, one is in Palawan. Palawan is Janet Lau representing WTK. Is it KTS?
KTS.
Don't just nod your head. Testing. KTS. Second is Tiong Tai King, representing proxy for RH. Third is Bao Zhang Wen, is it?
Bao Chung Ung.
Bao Chung Ung, representing who? Yeah. His own company. His own timber company. Fourth is.
And also timber transporting company.
Timber transporting companies. Fourth is He Kin Chiong in Puju. King Wu. King Wu, right? The famous King Wu. where the witness, global witness has exposed something. And the fifth one will be is a report. Report. Report SUPP. Candidate filled directly by Adinan Satem. Right? And these five are all proxies of huge timber companies. I think by filling all these proxies of huge timber company as their BN direct candidate or in the name of SUPP candidate, what Adinan doing is to tell the Sarawakian quite clearly that his administration is protecting all this exploitation of timber resources in Sarawak. Okay, the Malay saying talam duak muka, is that right? Is that the right word? You don't do as you preach. You preach one thing, do another thing. Alright? So I hope the people of Sarawak, the voters, can be clear about that. He has directly exposed his true color. Okay? 关于这个阿迪南之前说要打击非法伐木这些的这个言论。但是在他选他的候选人，国政的候选人的当额有四位是自国政自主候选人，有一位是阿迪南钦点的，但是以 SUPP 名义下葬。SUPP 名义下葬，不过这个人根本还都不是 SUPP 所指定的，只不过是阿迪南强硬 BSPPP 人联党接受以及点名他做 SUPP 候选人。五位候选人，就是 Report、Palawan、Tudong、Kidurong 和Puju。
不是Tanjung Batu。
不是Kidurong，没有Kidurong，Tanjung Batu。这五个都是代表着，都是这些伐木集团的代言人。暴露出阿迪南言行不一致，嘴说要非法伐木，但是实际的行动他在包庇 包庇资源的剥削。就希望沙洲人民可以看清阿丁山的这个真面目，言行不一致，讲一套做一套，讲要保护森林却委任剥削森林资源的公司的代言人做国政的候选人。 Alright
Reserve on this.
Okay. You are what?
You are.
I will present you in your next
meeting. Okay, alright, alright. Okay, alright. Any more question? Yes.
I want to ask you this, over here, if you want to make this capacity as available, what is
wrong? Under any democracy, anyone is free to contest. Okay. 他已经退党了，他已经退党了，这个是他的权利。不过我们是在质疑他背后的资源，背后的资源，援助的援，背后的资源和真正的目的，在参选。All right, I think it is their right, it is his rights. But what we question is the motive behind, the true ulterior motive behind, and the financier behind.The financier behind for him to contest. Okay, his financier behind the scene, and also his true motive, ulterior motive in coming out as an independent. Because he has repeatedly said that he joined DAP not because he wants to be candidate. That is what he said before.Today, Azmin is here. He's allowed in. Allowed. Well, seat allocation between DAP and SAR is ink the agreement that he has ink. And we hope that he will honor. I think credibility and holding.Is very important for a political leader. EC the first. 月，我们行动党这一方面，我们是全面遵守他所我们之对抗。This afternoon, That's why I call upon him to honor.
All right. 我这个复印。